to this evening's broadcast brought to you by the Sophia Academy Inspirational News Team. The goal of W Saints TV is bringing you coverage of all things Sophia. Today's top stories are looks like we got some breaking news this evening. Let's go to Jack Dillard, our field reporter.
Well, we're out here at Sophia Academy with the high school digging up an unidentified object that we have found here on the grounds. Well, it seems we're having a bit of trouble here finding this unidentified object. It's taking a lot longer than we expected, but we'll get there soon.
We are presently uncovering what we believe to be a time capsule. Dig it up and bring it inside.
Good day. Well, it seems today's the big day when we uncover our unidentified object. It seems that it's a Sophia Academy time capsule. Well, it took us a while because we had to call in our highly trained professional archaeologist. Oh, I almost forgot to introduce our highly trained professional archaeologist. Dr. Kolosinski, Dr. Horner, Dr. Rogers, Dr. Hazard, Dr. Harry, and last but not least, Dr. Hazen.
Mm-hmm.
Now, after that formal introduction, let's get this thing open.
Sorry I'm late.
Thank you for joining us, Dr. Pimento. Do you think you could help us uncover these findings?
Certainly. This looks like a cushion. You could sit on it. It says, Sophia Academy. No two are alike. How's the water bottle?
Dr. Matthew, what have you found?
I found a handprint.
Wow, that seems to be one certain large individual.
Oh, certainly. A magnet!
Doctor, do you think you could analyze that for us?
It says, like just as a seat cushion, Sophia Academy, no two are alike.
What is most magnificent about this water bottle, even though it is to provide water, of course, the slogan, transforming opportunities and transforming lives. This is by far the greatest finding. Sophia Academy.
Now that we know what happened 15 years ago, let's see what we're doing now. Let's send it over to Jack for his report on multi-sensory education. Back to you, Jack.
Thank you.
is our decoding section, where we actually take a sound and turn it into a letter. Are we ready?
Yes.
Good. Shake your rights. Let's start with an easy sound. Are we ready? All eyes on me. Remember, you're supposed to be using lowercase letters. Shake your rights. Eyes on me. Let's try a nice diphthong letter. Are we ready? Eyes on me.
T-H-S.
Okay, now we're about to do some tapping out words, our red words. What are red words? Yes.
Words that you can't sound out. Words. They don't sound like you sound out.
And let's stand up and let's tap it out on our arm. Alrighty, remember, we write from left to right. So if you're right-handed, you tap from the shoulder out. If you're left-handed, you tap from the fingertips to the shoulder. Are we ready?
Yes.
All right. What's our word?
Through.
Spell it.
T-H-R-O-U-G-H.
We actually write it on the paper. Now we have our line paper. Remember that the H goes all the way to the attic, and the G goes all the way to the
Thanks, Jack. And now a word from our sponsors.
This is a special announcement from Sophia Academy's 7th graders. Public speaking has now come to Sophia Academy.
Public speaking is being incorporated into the middle school language arts curriculum during the current school year. Our primary goal is to help our students become more comfortable speaking in front of a group. We will also have the opportunity to participate in the annual diocesan oratorical contest against the other 16 area Catholic schools. The first thing we learned is how to grab the audience's attention. We have learned 5 ways to begin a speech. Our 7th graders will demonstrate these methods. The first one is to pose a question. Here's Jessica to demonstrate posing a question.
What is the scariest thing you can imagine doing? The second one is to provide a surprising fact or statistic. Here's Nathan to demonstrate a surprising fact or statistic.
Studies have found that as many as 70% of people say that public speaking is the thing they are most afraid of. The third one is to tell a story relevant to the topic. Here's Trey to demonstrate.
Basketball team before the championship game, I had gotten hurt and could not play. The coach thought I could help by asking each member of the team to try really, really hard. I practiced and practiced what I wanted to say. I was so nervous, but because I practiced lots, I got the team ready to play. It felt good that I helped even though I did not play. The fourth one is to imagine something related to the topic. Here is Connor to demonstrate asking the audience to imagine something related to the topic.
Imagine yourself winning the 2014 oratorical contest. How absolutely cool that would be. The fifth one is to repeat a famous quotation that somehow relates to the topic.
The famous coach Vince Lombardi once said, "A dictionary is the only place that success comes before work. Hard work is a price we must pay for success." Here's Eric to demonstrate using famous quotations.
This basketball coach John Wooden often told his players Failure to prepare is preparing to fail.
In addition to our voice, we also communicate through our emotions, our body language. We practice these by using the statue game. I'll say a particular emotion, and the students will demonstrate it. Fear. Surprise.
Now let's see what else Sophia has been up to.
Amara, we sure do have a lot to be proud of at Sophia Academy. We do well in sports, get a wonderful education, and learn to give back to our community. Hey, let's go talk to Ms. Noggle. She'll share a little about our service requirements.
I got a question.
Yes, Amara.
What can we do in the city of Atlanta for community service?
That's a very good question. There are a lot of you who have done service here in Atlanta. Laura, for instance, you work at the zoo.
Altogether, I have 310 hours.
Wow, that's really good. It's good. You don't get paid for it, do you?
No.
But you put all those hours in.
Yes.
How about you, Will?
I just mainly do some community service with my church.
How about you, Annie? You have an interesting service project that you did.
I've created some fundraisers for the Save a Limb Fund. It helps people who need bone treatment that would can't get it, and they would otherwise get an amputation or suffer from a deformity.
That's awesome. You know, in the middle school, our service project is what we call the backyard mission trip. So any of you who are here in eighth grade may have been a part of that, because I think it's important for us to go into our own backyard first, in the areas that we live, and then go to somewhere.
I thought that it was cool how, even though they didn't have much at all, like the people there, they're still very happy, very giving too. Even though they didn't have much to give, I mean, they're willing to give stuff up.
Yeah. Good job, everybody.
That was a great report. Now let's go to Matt Harry for sports.
Thanks, Will. And here's some highlights from the Sophia Academy Athletics.
Thank you, Matt. On Wednesday, October 16, the Sophia Academy Eagles boys soccer team became the co-champions of the Atlanta Private Athletic Conference soccer tournament. The tournament kicked off with a victorious game on Tuesday afternoon, which led the Eagles to the championship game. Last year was the team's inaugural year for the sport, and they proved to be fierce competition when they took the championship. Congratulations to all hardworking players and coaches. The boys' basketball team is currently undefeated so far this season.
Sounds great. And the Sophia Academy middle school girls volleyball team ended their season successfully with a win. After defeating the Swift School in the first round, the Eagles went on to win the championship match against the Waldorf School. Congratulations to the champions of the athletic conference tournament, the Sophia Academy Eagles.
Go Eagles! Good morning, Ms. Corgan. Can you share with us your vision of Sophia Academy and how we can soar like eagles in the future?
Max, thank you so much for asking. That's one of the most important things I like to talk about, and it gives me so much joy to talk about the future of Sophia Academy. God has great plans for all of us. In Jeremiah, he tells us that he has great plans for each one of us. And that goes for not only individuals, but also institutions and companies and everyone who has a plan and wants to be in God's will. So when we communicate with him, he gives us those visions so that we can future glorify him. And that it gives us so much pleasure while we're here on earth until we return to our heavenly home with him. When I think about the future of Sophia Academy, I think about all of you because you're our oldest students. And what would I want for you to experience? Well, first of all, I'd want you to experience an educational opportunity that is better than any other thing that you could get anywhere else. That starts with the faith component, forming you in the image of Christ, then giving you the academics, the athletics, the fine arts, the technology, all those things so that you can be the very best person that you can be. Another thing that I would like for you all is for us to grow in our high school, to give you more social opportunities, to give you more friends and more acquaintances that you have experiences with, and that would increase your network so much. And then also, for now, not for in the future, I would love to see us be able to get the land next door to be a field for you so that we could have more sports on this campus. And then also the building that is contiguous to that would be a beautiful place for you all to have a high school. God has given me that vision for you all, to have that land, to have that building, and I've claimed it in your name that we have it as soon as possible. You all have taken a visit over to that building and to that land. You've seen it, and now let's show it to everyone else. This is the land next door. This is our building, the field next door that could be for Sophia Academy, and then the building next door that could be our high school. This is a larger picture of that building. As I said, we've claimed it for Sophia Academy, so now let's go out and get it. All of you who are listening to this message today, please help us expand our high school. Help us expand it literally by getting this land, this building for these students so that we can complete God's plan for Sophia Academy to have about 300 to 400 students in our school community. It would be a beautiful thing, and with all of those students glorifying God, it would just be a heavenly place on earth. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Corden.
Let's follow the eagle to see where he has landed us in the future.
As you can see, this is a building for Sophia Academy's High School. It looks like there's enough space for the eagles of the future.
Look over there, that's like a perfect place for our outdoor activities.
This campus would be a good addition to the campus we have already.
We can spread the word to our friends and neighbors about all the opportunities we have here at Sophia Academy. Then they may want to become part of.
Just think of all the electives and extracurricular activities just waiting for us here in the future of Sophia Academy.
I am only one person. What can I do to help this dream become a reality?
Yeah, we have so much to be proud of. Adding this building and a field would make it an even better school. I just can't wait!
I think this is our call to action today on this 15th anniversary of Sophia Academy to go forward and to proclaim how blessed we are to be members of a dynamic community of believers.
On behalf of Sophia Academy, thank you for watching this evening's broadcast. Have a great night, and may God bless you.
I used to think that I could not go on, and life was nothing but an awful song. But now I know the meaning of true love. I'm leaning on the everlasting arms. Can see it, then I can do it. If I just believe it, there's nothing to it. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar.
I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly. I was on the verge of breaking down. Sometimes silence can seem so loud. There are miracles in life I must achieve. But first I know it starts inside of me. Then I can be it. If I just believe it, there's nothing to it. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can show. See me running through that open door. I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly. Oh, I believe I can fly.